Praxis Prepper.
Everybody, this is Praxis. A lot of fans and subscribers to my channel have recently been asking me why I've been essentially mute on the topic of looting and riots and police brutality, a lot of it being caught right on video, that it's been exemplified all over the United States at the moment. One of the big reasons, and you can kind of tell from the setting that I'm shooting this in right now, is that I chose many years ago to live in a place where I'm a little bit separated from that type of thing. Living out in the sticks, in the country, myself and the other people who have chosen to live here, have some breathing room from a lot of that. We don't have to kind of take the pulse of our town before we wonder whether or not it's safe to step outdoors. But that said, it is on my radar, and it's on the radar of anybody who's into prepping and preparedness, because social unrest is unfortunately a natural part of human society, human existence. We haven't perfected everything yet, and when things get rough, violence oftentimes bubbles out of that. So, you know, the fact that we're seeing this right now is not at all surprising, and it's almost, to some degree, unfortunately, hardly worth even commenting on. You know, we've been going through this pandemic disease that's been creating a lot of suffering. That's also created economic, hardships, which are creating more suffering, and having anxiety and anger come out of that are totally natural. Now, a lot of the protests are related specifically to police brutality, and there are, unfortunately, just far too many examples of, you know, police abusing their power. Now, that it doesn't at all mean that all police are bad. I personally know a lot of really wonderful police officers, not to, you know, speak for them, but I know that, you know, were I a police officer and there were these really horrible cops that just are obviously not cut out for that. They've got anger issues, they've got fear issues, you know, whatever their issues are, it would bother me as a police officer to have them also called police officers, because it gives me a bad name. I'm a camera operator, and if suddenly camera operators around the country started doing these horrible things, I would really be irritated by that. A, because they're doing horrible things, and it's just, as a human being, you don't want to see people doing that. But then on top of that, it gives me a bad name. Unfortunately, that's happening to a lot of police officers right now, where, you know, because there are, you know, a limited number of really bad police officers that just, you know, cannot deal with the stress of the job, or they're just bad people to begin with, it's giving everybody a bad name. And it's unfortunate, but it's a situation that we're dealing with at the moment. How do we deal with that? How do we handle that? You know, to talk a little bit about, like, kind of what I'm thinking about all of this. Like I said before, it's something, the idea of social unrest is something that I've been preparing for some time. One way of dealing with that is to get into an environment where it's not, you know, right up in your face all the time. The other is obviously being able to have the ability to defend yourself through whatever means, you know, work for you legally in your area. In addition to that, just, you know, working to, you know, model positive actions for yourself, your family, and the area that you live in. I think I'm a huge believer in the idea of, you know, do no harm, be the change that you'd like to see in the world, and spread those ripples out throughout the community. Really, the thing that helps violence the most is oftentimes the people that violently are reacting, quote unquote, against the violence. You know, it goes back and forth, back and forth. There's finger pointing one way or the other. In the title of this video, I talk about who's responsible for all of these riots. You know, there are people on the right that say that it's, you know, Antifa extremists that are doing it. There are people on the left that are saying, oh, it's all, you know, white supremacists and you know, fringe far right groups that are doing it. You know, there are people that are saying, you know, it's African Americans, they're just such a problem, you know, and everybody's trying to point fingers at some other group. You know, the violence that's going on, it's not really even directly related to the protests, and it is really being perpetrated by one group, a very clear group, and it is people who are angry and are willing to use violence to express that anger or to just vent the anger out of their system. And it doesn't really matter whether those are liberal violent people or conservative violent people, whether they're white or they're blacks. The key characteristic of these people is that they are angry people and they want to vent that anger out to the world. It's one of the reasons that I actually tend to side more with progressive politics, more liberal politics. The reason for that, if you have a group of people who are suffering and a group of people who feel marginalized and a group of people who feel like other people have it better than them, even if they are lazy, even if it's their own damn fault that they didn't pull themselves up by their bootstraps, if that mob of people is headed towards your house, it doesn't really matter whether you're right and they're wrong or not. All that really matters is the idea that there is a mob of angry people, possibly armed, headed for your house. And it doesn't really matter how much you insulate yourself. You put, you know, fences up, you can put walls up, you can have all types of weaponry in your house. If you have a critical mass of people who want to inflict violence upon you, even if they are dead wrong, even if they are just lazy people, it's their own goddamn fault that they're in the situation that they're in. I'm not saying that's the case, but even if it were, it doesn't make any difference when the bricks start flying and your head gets hit with the brick. The result is still the same. So very frequently, I tend to side more with progressive politics because I see that throughout history, right or wrong, if people start feeling like other people have it better than them, jealousy kicks in. That's the way humans work. And then violence oftentimes flows after that. Again, doesn't matter whether you're right, doesn't matter whether they're wrong. The result is violent, bloody revolution. And a lot of progressive politics try to circumvent that, to get to that place of equity in a way that doesn't involve throwing bricks. You know, that may not be your preferred way to do it, but in the real world where, you know, one of the possible ways that things can go is violence and looting and rioting and killing and murder, you know, sometimes a less than perfect option is better than being murdered by a violent mob. So yeah, that's where I am at the moment. It's just, you know, get yourself in a situation that's as safe as you can. Be prepared if things do get rough and you don't want to go outside of your house. You know, have things like food, supplies, water. I know every time I say have water in your house, everyone's like, well, why would the water shut off? You never know. You know, if your water supply is dependent upon electricity functioning for pumps to work and people riot and there's violence, or if people just don't want to go into work at the power plant or whatever the reason is, water can get shut off. It doesn't just magically come up out of the ground into your house. People actually have to work. Machinery has to be functioning to get that water into your house. So, you know, having all these things kind of in place can allow you some degree of safety if civil unrest starts to, you know, wrap around your area, if it unfortunately goes that way. I would love to see people settle their differences peacefully. That is the best way to do it. But, you know, we live in the United States. You know, one of our founding fathers, Thomas Jefferson, you know, said that, but I'm going to kind of paraphrase quote him here, that like the garden of liberty needs to be watered with blood, or the tree of liberty needs to be watered with blood occasionally. I like to think that that's not true, but maybe it is. And if it is true, it would be nice if that blood wasn't yours. That's it. Thanks for watching. This episode has been brought to you in part by Prescott Caliber Club and Jesky Defense Strategies. Prescott Caliber Club is a federally licensed firearm manufacturer and retail store specializing in firearms, survival gear, and producing great online content. If you want to thank them for supporting this channel, go check them out at prescottcalclub.com. Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.